I am very happy to be here on behalf of my co-authors, and now I am going to present on the socio-economic cultural factors influence egg consumption practices among 6 to 23 month children in Nepal. All of you know that in yesterday's presentation of Kendra, Kendra mentioned that the nutrition and food and dietary diversity in earlier presentation. So here I am mainly focused on the what are the facilitator for egg consumption, what are the barriers for egg consumption, and what we are doing for egg promotion, and what data shows till now. This is the presentation outline. I mainly focus on background and objective, study details, study sampling, findings, and conclusion. Here I am going to present the data from the mixed method. I present annual survey data for the quantitative perspective and for formative research data for the qualitative perspective. In the background, all of know about the nutrition situation of Nepal, and the current declining rate of nutrition is not sufficient to achieve the SDG on time. All of know about that. And while we're talking about the nutrition, diet, care, and health service comes first. And while we're talking about the diet, poor diet persists among the children 6 to 23 months. Our data also shows that only 46% consume minimum dietary diversity is recommended, and only 13% consume the egg. On the dietary recommendation, only 30% consume egg, which is the least consumed food group among the 8 food group in DHS survey. In the background, eggs are the chief resource of protein and micronutrient. Eggs significantly increase growth and sounding. In current global evidence shows that egg consumption per day by young children will decrease up to 47% of sounding. These are the current global evidence shows that. And increase egg consumption in low-income countries consider the improving diet and reducing undernutrition. Changing food practices is not easy. It is difficult, and there are many factors. Earlier presenter shows that there are the social, cultural, and economic factors influence the food choices. And this study focus on to explore the socioeconomic and cultural factors that influence egg consumption among children 6 to 23 months in Nepal. This is the study design for the qualitative study. In qualitative study, we conducted the annual survey. It is the monitoring survey for the Suara project. And I present here the annual survey 2017 and 2018 data regarding to the egg consumption. And it is a repeat cross-sectional annual monitoring survey. And data collection was done in the ODK, and ethical consideration was taken from the Nepal Health Resource Council, and data analysis was done in the Strata 14. Here is the sampling methodology we applied in our survey. We select the 16 districts representing the 42 Suava districts, and from each district we select 2 municipalities, and from each municipality we select 3 wards, and from each wards we select the 2 sub wards, and at the end we select the 33,648 households of mother having the child less than 5 years. And for this analysis, only data included for the mothers with child 6 to 23 month years old. And for this, in 2017, the total sample size is 1385, and for 2018, total sample size is 1460. And the data set taken for here is the 24-hour dietary recall method, and primary respondent with the mother. This is about the study details for the qualitative study. The qualitative study was done in 2018. And in qualitative study, we want to explore the what are the barriers and what are the facilitators for the certain behavior. And egg consumption is one of the behavior among those. And for this study, ethical consideration was taken from Nepal Health Resource Council, and data collection was done in the 3 purposefully selected districts to represent three three agroecological zones is seen in the map. Three districts were the Bhojpur, Bajang, and Rupandihi. And those three districts are out of 16 annual survey districts. And in the survey tools, there is the focus group discussion. There are altogether 16 focus group discussion was done with the mother, grandmother, father, and health worker, FCSB, and SUARA frontline worker also. And there are 30 participant observations were conducted, and 30 in-depth interview were conducted. And the data analysis was done in the ENBO10. This is the findings scenario of the first annual survey, which was conducted in 2017. In the first annual survey, total egg consumption among the 6 to 23 months children was found is almost 11%. And there is some variation in urban rural and agroecological zone, and increasing the equity quintile, egg consumption practices is also the increasing in trend, and in caste ethnicity disadvantage is the higher rate of egg consumption. And this is just a first annual survey, and there are not too much program intervention at that time, and it is still low. And so we explore the what are the factors facilitated the egg consumption, and what are the factors barriers for the egg consumption, so that can help us our program focused on those factors. Here is the one main facilitator to egg consumption is reinforcement of information about benefits of egg consumption through SUARA platform and health mothers group meeting. And those also mentioned by the FCSB that people have good information regarding the benefit of egg consumption, got information regarding the benefit of egg consumption from SUARA program and through SMG. Almost all the community events, we promote the egg, like in the food demonstration session, recipe promotion session. Egg is a compulsory item for food demonstration session. And in the celebration of Key Life event with the Thousandish mothers, egg is the compulsory item to put in a gift basket of the Key Life event. And like in the every training, every meeting, one item should be the egg to promote the egg. We are doing on that way, and this is also ordered by the FCSB. Another one facility is the chicken ownership. If the household have the chicken ownership, then the egg consumption practices is automatically high in there. And there are some voices from the Thousandish mother and father. By raising more chicken at home, egg consumption can be improved. And similarly, same type of information was from the father of Bajang. I have been rearing 6 hens at my home and feed eggs to the children regularly. This type of voice also came from the target group. And other one is the privacy to children and their growth and health. And in the household, privacy was given to their children in the house, their children growth and health. If we talk about the more on the child mental and physical growth and health, then they are ready to feed the egg to the child. And this type of facilitator are from the qualitative findings. And aside from the facilitator, there are lots of barriers to consume the egg also. The one barrier is the poor access to market and limited availability of eggs in the market. If they are ready to eat the eggs to the child, but the egg availability in the market is limited. And poverty and perceived high cost of purchasing egg. And they mentioned that there is the poverty and the cost for the egg is high. This type of perception are also in the community. And low chicken ownership and egg production in the household. Chicken ownership and egg production is not practiced in all the household. in cultural and religious taboos and restriction of the egg, and there are the vegetarian also in the community, and prohibition of the rearing and eating chicken and chicken eggs in the some castes. In there are the some caste ethnic group and some caste ethnic group, there is the egg not eaten, there is the regular not eaten egg, and these are the their practices. And one major barrier is to misconception regarding risks of egg consumption, such as children getting ill. They feel that after eating the egg, children getting ill and not being able to digest the egg. Egg not being digested by the children. This type of voice are from the Thabrin's mother of Bojang. She said that there are also other taboos, like if the child of 6 months or 7 months is fed with egg, the child will not be able to develop voice, or even teeth will not come. This type of voices are from the Thabrin's mothers. In the year, the comparative data from the 2017 and 18. In 2017 and 18, there is the slight change in the egg consumption practices. From 17 to 18, 7 percentage point was increased, and which was statistically significant also. This is the overall. And while we saw the this graph, this is the change in egg consumption practices in the subgroup. While we see in the subgroup wise, in all of the subgroup has increased the egg consumption practices, but in rural and urban area, both has the significant difference in egg consumption practices. And similarly, in ecological zone, hill population has the egg consumption practices is significantly different. And in equity quintile subgroup, second lowest and middle income group had the egg consumption practices, which is significantly different. But in other group also, it increased, but not significantly. And well, in the caste ethnicity wise, disadvantaged Janjati has increased more than the other caste. And disadvantaged Janjati, Dalit and Brahmin Kshetri had a significant difference. In the conclusion, here I want to share that egg consumption among young children is a dietary practice heavily influenced by the socioeconomic and cultural context. But addressing these factors is not only the prerequisite to a successful policy or program, but it's possible as shown by the increasing trend. It's possible by the motivation dialogue with mother and by other SBCC, and it can be possible. And focus on improvement in access to eggs by continuing promotion of household egg production and promote availability of eggs in the market. And there is the one barrier is the availability and the market access. Therefore, focus to the access and market availability is one of the important factor for egg promotion. And it would be better to include egg consumption campaign can display the sum of the egg specific misconception. So egg consumption campaign may promote the egg consumption behavior in the community. That's all. Thank you all for your listening.